I'm very pleased to join you tonight as we celebrate the three milestones that have been talked about by many speakers and the shared history that binds Canada and Poland together. This year also marks the 100th anniversary of the birth of the Polish community in Windsor, which played such a big role in building the Canadian auto industry there. These anniversaries remind us how much we as Canadians have benefited from Canadians of Polish descent, more than 800,000 strong in this country today, how much you have done to help build our great country.
It was in 966 AD that the Slavic tribes, Polans, created their own nation, christening it Poland, and forever affirming themselves as Poles. Yet in the country's long history of 1,042 years, its people have spent 213 of them in bondage. In the year 1795, Poland's greatest strength waned as it became vulnerable to its neighbors. The result was a division and an eradication of the Polish nation, an astounding three times, and the beginning of the Polish diaspora. With Poland's freedom merely 40 years old, its diaspora has a rich and storied history. In thanks to the nations that embrace them, the Poles have contributed their hearts and minds, so much so that many of them have become synonymous as nationals of these nations. Situated on the left bank of the Detroit River and bordered by the American city of Detroit, Michigan, Windsor is Canada's southernmost city and largest border city. This makes it one of the most important transportation centers in all of North America, and the largest transportation corridor in the world, carrying 40% of the trade turnover between Canada and the United States. Interestingly, the 1930 construction of the Windsor-Detroit's crossing characteristic landmark, the Ambassador Bridge, was overseen by a Pole, Rudolf Modrzewski, the son of celebrated Polish actress Halina Modrzejewska. The first wave of immigrants from the 1800s to World War I were considered forbred immigrants. They came to America mainly for economical reasons, but also for religious and political reasons. It was from the Polish settlement located in Detroit around 1850 that Windsor saw its first arrival of Poles. Furthermore, the growth of manufacturing and automotive industries prompted an influx of Poles at the beginning of the 20th century. In 1908, the first Christian Polish family settled in Windsor, thus establishing 100 years of settlement, though there were Polish immigrants in the city as early as 1881. By 1915, 300 Poles had arrived in Windsor, and the coming three distinctive waves of mass immigration to Canada would amount to over 45,000 Poles between 1914 and 1939. In 1939, Poles at Windsor gathered for the war effort. The result was the formation of a recruiting center in Windsor under General Bronisław Duk to enlist volunteers for the Polish Armed Forces. To popularize this action, a bi-weekly publication, Relief Force, Fighting Poland in America, was published in 1941 and 1942. One prominent organization that rose from these military actions was Post 126 of the Polish Army's Veterans Association. It was established in 1932 and formed completely of those soldiers from the Polish fronts of World War I. In 1946, Post 126 was integral in establishing the Women's Auxiliary, which at first consisted of only 33 women. Both institutions became part of the Canadian Legion in 1952. They continue to focus on Polish culture and assistance to World War I and World War II veterans. A monument to these Polish Canadians and those who perished in the war currently stands at Windsor's Heavenly Rest Cemetery. The Polish community is concentrated within central Windsor along Langlois Avenue, Ottawa Street, and Walker Road. The community's most prominent symbol, the Roman Catholic Church of the Holy Trinity Parish, is embedded in the heart of this village. It is surrounded by other Polish institutions, Dom Polski Hall, the Polish Credit Union, the Convent of the Ursuline Sisters, and the European Market, amongst others. Polonia Park Housing and the Polonia Center Club stretch the community's boundaries further, both physically and financially through their support and financial contributions to the Polish community. Windsor's Polonia is present in business, faith, and various other organizations. The Holy Trinity Parish, constructed in 1918 and consecrated in 1919, is the center of the spiritual and secular life of Polish Canadians in Windsor. The Holy Trinity Church arose as only the fifth church in Windsor and the fifth Polish church in Canada. Since its consecration in 1919, the parish has expanded membership from 50 families to about 1,100 families today. The resilience and sustainability of Windsor's Polish immigrants and their indebtedness to their new home is best embodied in the figures of the church, the Reverend Fathers, and the Ursuline Sisters. Monsignor Lance Fnuk was assigned to the Holy Trinity Parish to take on the role of church pastor, but he would also intrinsically link community to church. In 1965, Fnuk's continuous efforts with communist-dominated Poland brought the arrival of 10 Ursuline Sisters to attend to the needs of the congregation. Then, in the late 70s, Monsignor Fnuk saw an increasing need for housing for Polish immigrants. The political turmoil within Poland resulted in a wave of immigration in the midst of Soviet oppression. This solidarity immigration brought a continuous wave of Poles to Windsor throughout the 1980s. Out of this need, the Polonia Park complex was built in 1980, consisting of 41 buildings and 342 apartments. Polonia Park is not only a housing complex, but a gesture on behalf of the Poles, their ambition to give back to the city. Today, it is a symbol of the strong bond between the Polish community and the city. Monsignor Fnuk passed the parish on to a man of equal character and strength, Father Piotr Sanchenko, who was appointed parish priest in 1983. It was Father Sanchenko who oversaw and participated in the third wave of mass immigration of Poles to Canada between 1980 and 1992 due to the Solidarity movement. Through the intervention of Father Sanchenko, many people made their way to Windsor from refugee camps all over Europe. Under his supervision, the church was systematically renovated and beautified. In the year 2000, a statue dedicated to Pope John Paul II was erected in the churchyard. In 2003, Father Sanchenko ended his ministry, and Father Roman Vashkiewicz took on the duties of the parish priest. He has taken upon himself the recent rebuilding of the church for the comfort and accessibility of the whole parish. Recently, Father Sławomir Swaczek has joined the parish as vicar. He assists Father Roman in ministry and various Polish organizations. The immigration of the Ursuline Sisters of the Agonizing Heart of Jesus came in 1965, which is a great accomplishment for that time. Thanks to 2 years of efforts by Father Fnuk, 10 convent females were permitted to leave Poland. The sisters came with an impressive educational background, serving as models for their students at the Polish Language School, which has become their domain and legacy. Up to 1985, Sister Małgorzata Gorska carried out the functions of superior. From 1985, Sister Magdalena Budniak now carries out the duties of superior. The Polish Language School was founded in 1925. Classes remained small during the early decades of the school's operation, but grew drastically after World War II. They were moved from the Dom Polski Hall and finally to St. Angela School. Upon arrival, the Ursuline Sisters immediately took a strong interest in the preservation of the Polish language, so they taught these classes themselves. In 1983, the Ontario government approved the teaching of Polish at various grade levels. The federal government subsidized it with donations covering the remaining costs of operation. The Polish school not only teaches language, but also promotes Polish history and culture during ethnic holidays and local Polish events. Canada has had a rich history of achievement from the Poles it has accepted. Many have given back to Canada in their roles as political servants. Alexander Edward Kieszkowski, who completed his education as a civil engineer in Paris, was the first Polish immigrant MP to be elected to the House of Commons, serving Quebec from 1867 to 1870. Another first was Dr. Stanley Hajdasz, who became the first Minister of State for Multiculturalism in 1972.
Myśli moje często wracają do mojej młodości, do domu rodzinnego, tego domu, który był napojony polskością i religijnością.
Po raz pierwszy w historii Kanady polityk polskiego pochodzenia obejmuje tak poważną funkcję w strukturze politycznej tego kraju. Jest to rzeczywisty powód do dumy dla kilkuset tysięcznej Polonii kanadyjskiej.
Also, Jesse Fliss was MP Parkdale Hyde Park in Toronto, parliamentary secretary to the Minister of Transport and the Minister of Foreign Affairs. Many of these have become so assimilated into the culture that they are more identified as simply Canadians rather than as Polish Canadians. Many are second-generation Poles, benefiting from the hardships endured by their immigrant parents.
Mieliśmy wroga komunizm poza Kanadą, ale teraz nie mamy tego wroga, także teraz jest szansa budować nasz kraj. Ja mówię nasz kraj jako rodzony tu, zawsze śmieję się, rodzony województwo Saskatchewan, ale nasz kraj to jest tu, Kanada. I cieszę się, że Kanada pozwala dual citizenship. My nie musimy się wstydzić, że jesteśmy z polskiego pochodzenia. Nie. I'm a Canadian plus. Jak ja rozmawiam z studentami na wyższych szczeblach, ja im mówię, be a Canadian plus. And the fact that you have preserved your heritage language and your culture, you are a Canadian plus.
The celebrated broadcaster, writer, and reporter, Peter Zofsky, a Canadian legend, is son of the famous Kazimierz Zofsky, a renowned engineer and past Lieutenant Governor of Ontario and a Pole of noble birth. Paul Staniszewski is also among one of the most long-standing and patriotic members of Windsor's Polonia. After retiring from his legal duties as a judge in 1992, he devoted more of his time towards the support of Polish festivities within the local region. Also, legendary hockey player Wayne Gretzky descends from a Polish father, a Polish grandmother, and a Belarusian grandfather. One of Poland's most beloved and honored Poles is often not recognized as a Pole at all. Friedrich Chopin was born and raised in Poland. He made a second home in France and proceeded to develop into a musical virtuoso, producing some of history's most skillful and mesmerizing repertoire for the classical piano. It is in his footsteps that Daniel Nukoski seems to tread. Daniel was born in Canada to Polish parents in 1981. His higher education began at the Chopin Conservatory of Music in Warsaw. The young pianist continued with a merit scholarship at the prestigious Peabody Conservatory at Johns Hopkins University. Daniel has a special affinity for Chopin, as well as other Polish composers. He has been invited to perform in numerous international Chopin festivals in Paris, Rome, Vienna, Basel, Toronto, New York, Buenos Aires, and Warsaw. He has participated in Chopin competitions with amazing results. Second prize in the 1997 International Chopin Competition in Szczecin in Poland. The winner of the 2014th National Chopin Competition in Warsaw, and the semi-finalist in the international version of the competition that same year. Like Chopin himself, Daniel, with pristine technique and dazzling flexibility, has become an immense source of pride to the Polish community. Maria Filarska is a talented and revered artist in the community. A great source of pride, her work has regularly been a feature of the exposition at the Carousel of Nations. Her most recognizable work is her sculpture of the bust of Chopin. It is considered to be one of the best artistic expressions of the pianist's face. Jerzy Werbal is another serious and exceptional Polish artist. He continued painting and exhibiting his work in shows and galleries in Canada, the United States, and internationally. He has a thick, vibrant style and an unbelievable eye for color. His work is original, collectible, and affordable, a rare combination. The Poles have always had a fighting spirit. Tomasz Kuchaszewski carried the spirit of the Poles in the Windsor community. He did it as an international Kwajkuszyn heavyweight fighter. in demanding full contact stand-up Japanese karate style. Tomasz's achievements during his career were remarkable. Born in 1968 in Poland, he began by winning the Polish National Kwiatkowski competition in 1988 through 1990, became the Canadian champion in 1991, the 5 times international Shibudan champion, and then the world Shibudan champion in 1994 in Tokyo, Japan. In 1999, he added world kickboxing champion to his titles. He was a brilliant and intelligent fighter. Unfortunately, Tomasz passed March 8, 2008, at the age of 39. Yet his legacy is powerful. His opponents remember him as a generous and warm man. Beauty and intelligence have always been a trademark of Polish women, with their Slavic features and spirit. The Windsor community of Poles has its representative, Katarzyna Dziedzic, a native of Poland. In 2002, Katarzyna won the title of Miss Universe Western Ontario, and then went on to win the crown for Miss International Canada in 2003. It was the first time in 43 years of Canadian history that a woman of Polish descent became an ambassador of beauty for Canada. This title allowed her to represent Canada internationally in Tokyo, Japan. In the Polonia International 2004 pageant in Vienna, Austria, she placed first runner-up. Miss Dziedzic has an honors degree in criminology and sociology from the University of Windsor and is pursuing one in finance. An important feature of the Polish diaspora is the intellectual contribution that Poles have made to their communities. Solidarity-era immigrants were well-educated when they reached Windsor. They facilitated their transition into Canadian society very quickly. Today's Polonia is populated significantly by law officials, teachers, engineers, health professionals, artists, academic and business entrepreneurs, all who were part of the Solidarity immigration. In the vein of their predecessors like Marie Curie-Skłodowska and Michał Kopernik, Poles have dedicated themselves to the pursuit of knowledge. This is obviously defined by the Polish contribution to the University of Windsor, beginning with the Ursuline sisters, many of whom lectured at the university, to the gifted professors who work at the university today. Some interesting faculty positions were held by Poles in the past. Mateusz Gliński was director of the School of Music. Zbigniew Faulenbell was chair of the Department of Economics and dean of the faculty. Edward Kuffel was chair of the Department of Electrical Engineering, while Frank Borowicz was in the Faculty of Law. The current faculty is rich with hardworking researchers in many dynamic disciplines. Professor Jan Szyborowski of the Biology Department and the Great Lakes Institute of Environmental Research is a busy and prolific researcher, bringing in thousands of dollars to the university. Dr. Ewa Chalinska also works in environmental research. Dr. Jerry Sokolowski from the Department of Mechanical, Automotive, and Materials Engineering works in light metal castings technology research and has made a remarkable impact on cost savings in the automotive industry. Dr. Andrzej Sobieziak works in the same department, concentrating on research to define efficient use of fuel cells. There are many Poles in the Faculty of Physics. Dr. Mieczysław Czakowski, Dr. Frank Hojoy, Dr. Lucien Krause, and Dr. Władysław Kienzewski. He is particularly active in research on electron impact cross-sections for use by other physicists and astrophysicists. Poles are well represented in the liberal art disciplines as well. Dr. Anna Lanoszka in political science, Barbara Niewiczeka in educational development, and Christopher Wojcinski in law. Polish impetus and know-how have allowed a variety of Polish businesses to flourish in the city and the county. The first Polish businesses in the region were Black's Bakery on Langlois. Peter and Elsie Black arrived from Poland in 1918 and opened Black's Bakery that same year. The bakery prospered during the 20s, also helping those in need during the Depression. This family-owned bakery still prospers today, using the same Peterson brick hearth oven from 1918. The bakery is an institution, having been in operation for 90 years as of 2008. The Polish People's Home Association, Dom Polski Hall, is the second oldest ethnic club in the city of Windsor. It came into existence within the walls of Holy Trinity Church in 1925, and a plan was immediately set in motion to build the hall on Langlois Street. During World War II, Dom Polski had the distinction of hosting the Polish Army's recruiting station. Since 1930, when the club was built, it has been serving the Polish community in Windsor as a cultural festive center. Recently, the hall has been renovated and its new modern look continues to fulfill its significant ethnic role. Poles have also created their own financial institution. The St. Stanislaw and St. Casimir's Polish Parish Credit Union was founded in Toronto during mid-1945. Currently, it has grown to become one of the largest parish-based financial institutions in the world, with 20 branches scattered across Ontario. Founded on Ottawa Street, it is involved in many Polish community initiatives, sponsoring cultural and social events. The Polish community formed the Polish Social Club in 1951 with the intention of preserving Polish culture through community events. Another organization that brought the community together was the Polonia Sports Club, founded in 1953 by Post 126. In the 1980s, increased immigration allowed for the revival of the sports club, and today it has over 200 members. The Polish Alliance of Windsor, Branch 20, was also quite an active organization for many years, promoting cultural, traditional, and community events. Their youth groups were well known on the local and national scene. Last year, the national organization celebrated the 100th anniversary of its existence. Culture and art are embodied in the community. The Tatra Dance Ensemble came to existence in the Dom Polski Hall in the 70s. Today, this dance ensemble continues to serve as a cultural ambassador, presenting traditional Polish dances throughout the wider Polish community. The ensemble currently trains about 100 members in 5 different age groups. Internationally, the group has performed in New York, Michigan, and several times in Poland. Alongside Tatry, the theater vocal group Płomień is equally active. Płomień, meaning flame, was established in 1995 to preserve and promote culture through dynamic stage performances of Polish fundamentals. The presence of song, dance, theater, and poetry provide a diversified view of Polish culture to the residents of Windsor. The Carousel of Nations is a yearly showcase in which Polonia presents Polish culture. It is the city's multicultural festival, and Windsor's Polonia organizes the Polish Village each year since June of 1975. The festival includes exhibitions of Polish cultural achievements in Dom Polski Hall, carefully crafted by Windsor's Ursuline Sisters. Performances by the Tatry Song and Dance Ensemble, as well as Płomień, are featured. But the highlight is surely the tasting of Polish cuisine. The Polish Village is very popular amongst Canadians, attracting thousands over its duration. Another significant financial organization contributing to Polonia is Polonia Center, which has been a registered nonprofit charity since 1978. In 1996, the Polonia Center Academic Awards Program was established to encourage and support the younger generation of Poles in their pursuit of higher education. To date, over $500,000 has been contributed in support of cultural, sporting, religious, and humanitarian efforts, with an additional $50,000 contributed to the Holy Trinity Church's renovation and $3,500 contributed annually towards the Letty Library. In 2002, Polonia Center funded the creation of a website that concerns all aspects of the Polish community in Windsor, www.poloniawindsor.ca. As this organization celebrates its 30th anniversary, it is evident that it will be integral to the Polish community of Windsor for many years. Currently, there are a variety of businesses that are the result of the creativity of Polish Canadians. Enjoyment of food and drink are integral to Polish culture, and so these businesses are well represented. There is the quaint Crossroads restaurant at the corner of Langlois, within meters of Dom Polski, providing traditional home-cooked Polish cuisine. The European Market, located at Władysław Court, is a mecca for Polish and European goods in the city, even bringing customers across the border from the United States. The Polish community can also be proud to have two Polish-owned wineries in the region. Considered to have two of the finest offerings of wines, the Alexander Estate, owned by Alexander Bemben family, and the Colchester Ridge Estates Winery, acronym being CRU, owned by the Gorski family, are both growing quickly. The Colchester Ridge Estates Winery produces VQA quality wines. Both wineries have achieved astounding recognition and medals in various competitions. Poles have also entered the industrial sector, with companies like that of Gorski Transport. It was established by Tad Gorski, born in Windsor in 1922. This family business transports the high volume of goods moved throughout North America. Victoria Steel is also a Polish business, founded by Victor Bass. The business, now run by his two sons, assists in building many of Windsor's structures. The newly renovated Holy Trinity Church had Victoria Steel install the bell hanging in its highest tower. As well, Eagle Press has been a part of Windsor's manufacturing economy since its establishment by Tadeusz Polewski in 1959. Currently, it remains family-operated by the Polewski children. Their ever-changing location suggests expansion and excellence in the development of the largest in America's press technology. The Polish-Canadian Business and Professional Association has worked to link local Canadian and Polish businesses since its establishment in 1996. Jerzy Baryczki, the president of the association, has been in the forefront of many initiatives, including the creation of the association and the rebirth of the local Canadian-Polish Congress, followed by high-profile projects such as the twinning of Lublin and Windsor and the organization of Polish Weeks in Windsor. The association has succeeded in creating diplomatic arrangements to promote exchanges in business, science, and culture between the sister cities of Windsor and Lublin. In honor of the centennial of the Windsor Polish community, the city of Lublin is bestowing a gift upon the citizens of Windsor, the most representative piece of their own city, a beautiful bronze water fountain. It is a replica of the famous Lublin goat, the Kozy Grot, the city's symbol for the past 700 years. The Canadian-Polish Congress is responsible for the Polish initiative and the cooperation between all Polish organizations. The Congress has been in existence since 1944. In 2001, there was a reincarnation of the Congress Windsor branch. Recently, in June of 2008, the Congress was invited to Parliament Hill in Ottawa to meet with the Prime Minister, Stephen Harper, to commemorate the 150 years of Polish settlement by the Kashubs, our own 100th anniversary of Polonia in Windsor, and the 75th anniversary of the Canadian-Polish Congress. The ceremony held particular significance due to the lifting of Polish visa requirements and the signing of a social agreement undertaking a youth mobility program to strengthen ties.
Poland endured more than its share of suffering and oppression during the last century, first under the Nazis, then under the communists, but the Polish people have persevered, and now Poland is a leader in Eastern Europe. Indeed, it is becoming a leader, a NATO, a leader in the world, a model for countries struggling to achieve freedom, democracy, and open free market economies. And frankly, to see that transformation in Poland and for the way the Polish people so deeply understand the gift that is freedom and democracy that we have come to take for granted is truly inspiring. And the Poles are doing a great job around the world. In any case, I know that the Canadian-Polish Congress and the Canada-Poland Parliamentary Friendship Group have provided stalwart support for Poland during all its difficult years and its years of transition. Let me assure you that our government wholeheartedly supports your efforts, and we thank you for everything you have done, you are doing, and that I know you will do to advance Canada-Polish relations. Thank you very much. Happy anniversary. Merci beaucoup. Dziękuję.
A book written by Agata Rajski of the University of Krakow, entitled One Century of the Polish Community in Windsor, 1908-2008, has just been published. It is the first comprehensive, scholarly documentation of the Polish community in Windsor and will commemorate the people and achievements that have made this community possible. In this vein, Centennial gold medals will be awarded during the centennial celebration in recognition of those people whose exceptional volunteer work and support allow the Polish community in Windsor to thrive. Adam Mickiewicz, living as an immigrant in France, wrote, "The spirit of the Polish nation is the Polish pilgrimage. It has been so for the Poles of Windsor, immigrating here and embracing their new home without forgetting themselves. Polish settlement has been a testament to the value of openness and integration, the beauty of the plans and the initiatives that flourish from the partnership of two cultures. Windsor's Poles have made an enthusiastic effort to contribute to Windsor with their hearts, minds, and spirit, and they continue to push the city forward. Canada and other nations showed kindness in accepting Poles, and Poles continue to show their gratitude to these nations. Polish history is, in its essence, a history of its people, their ideas and passions, and perseverance. Now we can see very clearly that the Polish community becomes part of the history of Windsor and Canada."
A toast to Poland. May she always be free, may God protect her, and may she always be loving to her people. To Poland.